first thing I wanted to ask you is why now for Mortal Engines, both in terms of just the production timeline and your personal schedule, but also there's a number of things in this movie that feel pretty timely right now.
Ah, yeah. It's interesting. Well, these books first came to us about 10 or 12 years ago, actually, and they ended up being shelved because of the process of the rights to The Hobbit becoming free. So we ended up doing that, and when it came time to do this and finally think, okay, do we want to do it? Are we going to do it? If we're going to do it, we'd better do it now. What was interesting was it felt like it was the right time to do it. It was like fate had played a hand somehow in it. You know, we'd never set out to write films that, well, certainly not in this case, that are issues-based, or sending some kind of message, so to speak, because, you know, we wrote the script 3 years ago. But what you find in the process of making the films is that they become more and more relevant just naturally, because they're being made in that moment and then become moments where you want to reflect what's going on in the world. The themes of Mortal Engines, though, are universal, and the whole notion that mankind could destroy himself, I mean, that's been a theme that's run through, you know, the history of mankind forever.
That's for sure. I'm also, I constantly read books, and specifically books that are being adapted to film, so I'm fascinated by the adaptation process. So in this particular case, is there anything that was, one, really hard to cut, and two, even though the book is written in a really cinematic way, difficult to adapt to screen?
Yeah, there was you know, any work of such vast imagination as Mortal Engines, it's not an easy day at the office. But it's a puzzle, you know, and you've got to make the pieces work. You can't overwhelm the story with the great, just because of the great visuals, and vice versa. You can't undersell the visuals or underpower them. So getting that to work together was something. I think the main thing that I worried about was, you know, would people understand this world? And you have to, that's when you remind yourself, just show it. You don't have to drown people in the exposition. There is an amazing history in the books, if you read the books, about how we got here. But you realize at the beginning of a movie, when you're sitting there with the hot popcorn, you don't need a history lesson. So it's little things like that you, how are you going to get people into the world? Because once you get them into the world, escaped into that place, they're going to go with the characters.
One specific question for the adaptation process. What happened to Dog?
I love Dog. You know what? Well, because he's a wolf. That's what I love about him. He's wild, and I love that element. But in the end, it's pragmatic, you know, and it's would he have died? Because that would have killed me.
As I said that question, I'm like, wait, did I really want to see that?
Do you really want to see Wolf die?
I don't know.
I mean, Dog die. But I know. It was brilliant. The fact that he's called Dog is just perfect. Philip is so funny.